Lisa.
Yeah?
Jenny. How'd you do?
You walked all the way.
The village was a bit frozen, I thought.
Can I show you that?
Well, it's bigger than I expected.
There are seven of us. Eight now. Yeah, well, I know what you mean. The thing is, we haven't really got that together yet. Now, this is my little brother, Tom. I'm not allowed to call him little, but I keep forgetting. This is Jenny, Tom.
Hello.
How'd you do?
If you come a bit further down, I'll show you where we're going to have a vegetable garden. See, we're all into eating our own produce, but we haven't had time to do anything about it yet.
It's a lovely room.
It's a bit on the small side, but I think you'll be okay. It's got the best view in the house.
Oh, that really is beautiful. I'm so lucky. I'll be staring out of the window all day if I'm not careful.
Yeah, well, we'll leave you in peace for a bit. We eat dinner around about 7:30.
Oh, thanks. Thanks for everything.
Go on, Tom. It's your turn in the kitchen, remember?
What's that one?
This card depicts you, Sharon. And the crayfish depicts unknown dangers, possibly trickery. One is your outside influences, and it shows the breaking down of present situations. Shit.
What's your problem, then?
My life's crumbling, Jose.
What's the new girl like?
She's very fat. She's got a funny laugh.
There we are. Don't be longer than 15 minutes.
Where were you living before, Janet?
Manchester, actually. In a flat.
Oh, yeah.
Well, it's just a room, really. Beautiful little girl. She likes you.
About your school? I started the comprehensive next term.
A new school? Looking forward to that?
Don't know.
Now, are you going down to the river?
Of course, look at my boat.
Can I come with you? Will you show me the river?
If you like.
Same tree. Just think. London's down there.
Mustn't talk about London. Whoever doesn't know it's going to London.
Can I get in?
Yes. Hey, be careful! It was 2 years ago. My dad was driving. Brother Pete said they both died immediately. Never felt anything. But I think Mum was still alive when they took her to the hospital. They wouldn't let me see her. They should have. They let Pete.
And so you went on living in your parents' house?
Peter had this idea for a kind of commune. He said he was going to have loads of people. Now he wants to keep it small. When we advertised for an eighth person, Pete said we should take the first person who replied.
And so you got me?
Yes.
Second or third day. The kids actually locked me in the book, but I didn't dare bang or shout too loud. This way.
Yeah.
In case one of the other teachers heard me. I didn't want anyone to think I couldn't control my class. So I stood in there in the dark, whispering through a crack to the class, please let me out. Please, I won't be angry. They were fits of clothes. That sort of thing used to happen to me all the time.
It was incredible, man. I was standing outside one of those pudding shops, you know, in Istanbul. And this Turk comes up to me and says,
how do you call that thing that flies through the air? I said, hey, man, that's a frisbee. It turns out he wants to buy it. So...
I said, hey, man, look, like, we are going to Kabul, huh?
And, like, that's our only frisbee. He reaches into his pocket, and pulls out the biggest lump of dope you ever saw in your life. I mean, half a pound of it in a bowl. He said, I'll give you this for it. So we had a deal.
Okay.
Oh.
heavy border, man. Yeah. I mean, we can't cross it with the dope. And there's no way we're gonna throw it away. So, I say to him, look, man, there's only one thing to do with all that dope. Mm. Right? Smoke it! So, we went to this hotel, yeah? And we stayed stoned for a week. And man, we were high.
Enough for that kitchen. Now, what about that boat trip you promised me, eh?
Oh, Lordy, Piccabella Garden. Oh, Lordy, Piccabella Day. Oh, Lordy, Piccabella Garden. Oh, Lordy, Piccabella Day.
You teach me to row sometime? This afternoon. Go on.
I'll see.
Jump down, turn around, pick a bale of cotton. Jump down, turn around, pick a bale of day. Jump down, turn around, pick a bale of cotton. Jump down, turn around, pick a bale of day. Oh, Lordy, pick a bale of cotton. Oh, Lordy, pick a bale of day. Oh, Lordy, pick a bale of cotton. Oh, Lordy, pick a bale of day.
You take it in. Fingers crossed.
Hey! Wow!
Lovely.
It's really nice.
What do you put in this, huh? It is very good.
It's lovely. Thank you very much.
Yeah, hold on.
Come on, Tom. I'm racing, eh? Come on. It's not fair, I've got a handicap.
Infernal machine.
It's only got brandy instead of water.
It's a fiend, man.
Who's going to be first?
Me.
Hey, give it up. It's no good for you.
It's almost time you were in bed. Jenny, how about you?
Oh, don't think I could.
Come on. Hey, come on. It'll be a laugh. Yeah, go on. Come on.
I'll get it going for you.
Good stuff.
I've never smoked anything before. Not even cigarette.
Yeah.
No, really. I'd rather not, thanks.
You won't bite. Just try a little.
Just breathe in through the pipe. The liquid cools the smoke. It's beautiful.
No, I don't want to. I really don't want to. You go ahead. I'm awfully sorry, I was thinking. I've got some letters to write. I'll see you all a bit later.
I think you upset Slim Jim there, Pete.
See my photographs now.
Come on in.
These ones get a bit boring after a bit. They're all of the boat, just taken from different angles. We just got the boat that day, and I went a bit mad.
And a picture of the oars.
There's quite a few of the oars. Pete took this one of me rowing.
Oh, that's a good one of you.
Is this? It's one of the first pictures I ever took.
It's a good picture.
Your mother looks like a very nice woman.
It's funny.
What is it, Tom?
Suddenly saw her. Just a woman in a picture. Someone you could describe, like anyone. Usually, she's in my head, looking out with me. But now she's outside, being looked at by me, or by anyone who picked up the photo. She's far away.
Let me show you a photo of my family. I'm the only fatty in a family of thinnies. Mm. What do you think of that?
You don't look very cheerful.
It's because I hate having a picture taken. That's my mum. That's Dad.
You look like your dad.
Mm, that's what everyone says. If you were three times the weight and wore glasses, you couldn't tell us apart. Come on. I'll see you into bed.
Do you like it here?
Yes. You sure?
I'm very content. Happiest I've ever been, why?
You're not thinking of leaving, are you?
Absolutely not. I give you my word. Now, don't read too long, will you?
Bloody kitchen now. Tom, where's the, oh, there it is. Did it sound like Jenny was getting up?
Dunno.
Could you be a dear and shoot upstairs? Tell her I'm waiting to go.
Oh, Jenny. Thank God.
I must dash. Are you sure you'll be all right?
Oh, she'll be fine with me. Won't you, sweetheart?
Mummy's a good girl. Mummy will be back this evening. Bye, Tom. Bye, Jenny. And thanks.
Sally's coming too.
Oh, she is. Are you coming?
You going down the river?
Yeah.
Have fun.
We will.
to drag your boat up to the garage before the school term starts. How about tomorrow?
But me and Jenny are going for our last trip on Saturday. Aren't we, Jenny?
Mm-hmm.
Can't we bring it up on Sunday?
Yeah, I'll give you a hand with it on Sunday.
As long as it's up before school starts, that's what we agreed, remember?
I know.
Jenny! I'm sorry I'm so late. Did she go off all right? I just couldn't get away. I meant to phone you.
She's no trouble.
She can be hell at bedtime.
She was very good, really.
What a day. I went over to John's place and...
Come on, Tom. No more lazing about.
Go away.
Won't you get? By the end of today, you're going to be a completely organized schoolboy all ready for Monday.
To be organized.
Right. Oh, Pax! Right, I'll show you. Well done. Now, put everything that needs washing in the pile with your sheets, then we'll sort this room out.
Bye, Tom. See you on Sunday.
Sunday? You're going to be away all tomorrow, then?
Yes, I'm staying over at John's place.
But me and Jenny going on the river tomorrow.
I'll take Alice with you. She'd love it. Bye.
What a face. Should have brought your camera.
Treating them with tremendous respect.
Oh, no, wait a minute. No, Shock Corridor. Hey, look at this thing. Hey, we've got to go and see this. Shock Corridor is much like jumping headfirst into a cement mixer. Hey, can you imagine? They're doing cement out of mine already.
No more. you know you've been through something when you get out.
Here he is. Come on.
Paulsman.
Won't you come on down? Cheer up. There'll be other Somalities. Hey, don't get sad now, Astrid, you're somewhere. Look at me. Come on. It's been a fantastic summer. For me, anyway. I learned to recognise a blackbird song.
Except when it's a song thrush.
And I can tell a nightingale. Every other day, rowing on the river before any of the others were awake. All those walks.
With Alice.
Oh, poor Alice. Couldn't leave you behind, could we? Do you know, I think I know every inch of riverbank for 5 miles in each direction.
Thanks to me.
And I've learned to row.
Well, sort of. You still can't go in a straight line.
And all those wild flowers. And I've slept in a tent for the first time in my life.
Yeah, that was great.
Your fault. Too sure of yourself. What about that fire we built?
Yeah, that was great. That was the best thing.
And tomorrow, you put on your red cap and you go to school.
Ha ha ha! Jenny!